Ledwidge this morning from Mako Gold. Peter, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
Well, this is interesting. Tell us a bit more about the this manganese discovery at Korhogo.
Well, we call it, we're very excited about it for starters, and we call it an opportunistic discovery because as our geology team was out there mapping for gold on the Wangaloo permit, they encountered a lot of manganese, and so we kind of scurried and put a rock chip sampling program quite quickly, and then sent off it's a different analyzing technique, so we had to send that off to South Africa, and we turned that around quite quickly. So it is a big strike length on there.
And so this was done along two parallel 7 kilometer long units, was it?
That's right. And so just the fact that it's that long, and every single, we took 22 samples over those two parallel zones that each measure 7 kilometers, and every single sample kicked. The average was 22%, and the highest number was 33%. Viewers can go see current manganese mines to see what the various grades are, and we think that we might be onto something pretty interesting here.
So you're a long strike here from Shiloh Mining's manganese mine.
That's correct, and same rock units and so on. And if investors look at our ASX release, they'll see the footprint of the Shiloh mine, which is basically two pits stretched out over 1.6 kilometers. And here they can go on Google Earth and see it as well for themselves. And here we're looking at 7 kilometers strike length. So it's very early days, but we're pretty excited about it.
And so given what you've seen here, this has given you cause for evaluation, if you like, of the Korhogo Nord permit, has it?
That's right, because the northwest corner of the Korhogo Nord permit is actually situated in the same rock types. But even if Korhogo Nord had nothing in it, just the fact that we had 7 kilometers, it's pretty amazing, because there's four operating manganese mines in Côte d'Ivoire, and they're pretty small scale. They're all private, so it's really hard to get information on them. But this could be a positive thing, both for Mako as a company growth, as well as for Côte d'Ivoire as a country.
And just for those not familiar, manganese important when it comes to steel making and EVs.
That's correct. The majority of manganese is used for steel making. You can't make steel without it. And one of the other bonuses is in our analysis of the results. The phosphate content is very low, and that's a crucial element in steel making. If you've got high phosphate, then it doesn't work for steel making. So that's a very positive note on that. And as far as the EV, that's something that we need to do more work, metallurgical testing and things like that. That's in order to find out if it's valid for EV. But regardless, just the steel making industry with China, who knows what they're going to do as far as that, so we could get in on that wagon.
So Peter, where does this manganese opportunity, where does this leave Mako in terms of its gold focus?
It doesn't change anything, as right now, we're equally excited, actually more excited about our Napier project, where we have our maiden resource just under 900,000 ounces. And the intent is to grow Napier, and actually we're hoping to start RC drilling on that in a not too distant future.
Good to speak, Peter. Thanks for your time.
Thank you. My pleasure.